Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's your girl Fanny Lungu, back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. Like I said, my name is Fanny Lungu, and on this channel we post reaction videos each and every day. So if there's something in particular that you guys want us to react to, let us know by dropping the link in the comment section below and we'll do it for you. You can check out our second YouTube channel called Fanny and Jesse 2.0, or you can hit the subscribe and enjoy our weekly content. We've got a podcast called Diving In with Fanny and Jesse, and we have some amazing conversations which you guys don't want to miss. You can find us on iTunes, Spotify, Podbean, this channel, or our second YouTube channel for the visual. And we've got a Patreon. You guys can feel free to become members and we'll appreciate. Big shout out to everyone that has been supporting us so far. Thank you for subscribing, liking, commenting, sharing. Everything that you guys are doing is very much appreciated. So yeah, I hope you guys are doing all right and may you stay blessed. Today I'm going to be reacting to Shamsi Speaks to Christian MMA Fighter Speaker's Corner. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
What's happening, man? How are you? Good.
I was just asking you. You know, is it Arabic or is it?
Huh?
Is it Hebrew?
Militia.
Ah, okay. Well, I was going to ask you that you believe, and as a Muslim you believe, God does not change.
Yeah.
Correct? God does not change.
Yeah.
God is perfect all the times. Okay? So when God became a baby, did he change? So God was a baby before?
Huh?
Was God a baby before?
That's a different context. That's a different thing.
What do you mean?
Being a baby.
Yeah.
Still the same God.
How? Because a baby goes baby.
It's only a physical form.
Yeah, but
it's still the same character. That means change.
No, it wasn't, because character of God is not a need of someone to take care of him.
Huh?
Character of God is not in need of someone taking care of him. So if God never changed, how come we know God is not in need of no one? It was in need of him. So if we say he didn't change, we know that Mary, she was taking care of him. But we know God, no one take care of God.
Yeah, but the angels will still take care of him, don't they?
Yeah, but God doesn't take
care of him. Angels still serve him.
Yeah, but the angels, no one
serve him.
No, serve him, correct.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
no one taking care of God means God is depend on you. For example, if Mary never changed his nappy, he will start stink. So he had to rely on Mary to change his nappy. That's not God.
That's God in manifestation.
The point I'm making, that God against God nature.
He wants the experience.
Yeah, but you agreed God has not changed.
Yeah. I'm jumping.
Yeah, but we can establish.
I'm not going to talk to you.
But we can see clearly from the Bible that someone was taking care and looking after of Jesus. That cannot be the same God. No, he wouldn't. So why she was breastfeeding him then? Why she was breastfeeding him?
That's the experience. That's life experience.
No, you put off topic now. You said he will survive without Mary, but he was relying on Mary's milk. She was breastfeeding him to keep him alive.
James, it's not a miracle, it doesn't make sense. God still had the experience within our flesh, within the flesh.
No, but we're not talking about.
He's still God.
No. Yeah, but I'm not talking about experience. I'm talking about the foundation I've laid down. That all of us, Jews and the Christians and the Muslims, we know God is perfect and there's a lot of change. If this is the case,
Hashim, please. That means his character doesn't change.
Yeah, okay.
That's mean because he's a
determine his attributes, okay? So is it from God's attributes to rely on someone else?
Reliance.
Yeah. No, if what? That's it. God doesn't rely on anyone. But we know Jesus relied on Mary's milk, her breast milk, to survive.
That was a man.
He still get milk from heaven.
He didn't get milk from heaven, he was getting from the breast. But he didn't. No, but he didn't. But even if he got milk from heaven, he still rely on something outside, which is milk. God doesn't rely on nothing outside him.
The Father and the Son are one.
But they're not one. Because the Father.
That's your idea. That's your belief.
From the Bible. The Father doesn't rely on Jesus.
That's true. That's true.
See, so they're not one. Jesus, because let me ask you, James. If the Son.
Is not one with the Son.
If Son.
Since I and the Father are one. In the Bible, since I and the Father are one.
No, but there's a context.
That's the context. The Father and the Son are not the same.
So the Father is the same.
The Father and the Son are not the same.
No, because the context of this, yeah? Jesus said, as me and the Father. Listen, James. He's speaking to his disciples, yeah? He said to his disciples, just me as a Father, we are one. I will pray you, my disciples, you will be one with us too. Doesn't make them God, mean in purpose. God sent Jesus to teach the people how to worship God. The disciples do the same thing. What I will tell you, look, in the Quran, Allah.
Jesus came, he says, I and the Father are one.
Yeah, but it's not. No.
No one is able to stand to you out of the Father's hands.
Okay, so when Jesus became a baby, was that the Father as well? Who's that the Father?
That's not the Father.
It's not. It's not the one.
It's not the Father.
Let us start. God's
yeah. Because I know there's no point in him struggling.
It's not because when Jesus.
You jump in.
According to the Bible, when Jesus was on the cross, he was praying to someone out there. So they're not one. Because James, you are one as a human body, yeah? If you ask me to help you, you and I will not one. We are a separate person. You understand? So what I'm gonna tell you, James, yeah? I know clearly.
But even the human body communicates with itself.
Yeah, but not someone outside.
Our Father, the one who's in heaven.
Yeah, but he said our Father, the one who's in heaven.
Why not you read this question?
And according to Paul, the Father will be sitting on the throne and Jesus will be next to him. So they're not one, they're separate. And let me ask you, James, is there anyone who has more knowledge than God?
No.
Okay. Jesus said clearly that no one knows the hour, even himself. He said only the Father knows the hour. And we know Jesus is not the Father. Because you believe Jesus is the Son, correct? The Holy Spirit is not the Father. So this statement, James, what is amazing about this statement, that's exactly what Allah said to Prophet Muhammad to say. If they ask about the hour, say no one knows except Allah. Jesus said the same thing, no one knows except the Father, okay, except God. So what I'm saying clearly, Jesus said, I'm going to my Father and your Father, for my Father is greater than I, but there is no one greater than God.
Jesus is greater than the Son.
Yeah, but no one greater than God. If Jesus
is greater than nobody is greater than God.
So the fact there is someone.
Jesus is still God the Son.
Yeah, but there's no one. If Jesus is God, no one should be greater than him. James, clearly doesn't make any sense. James, let me ask you something. If I tell you I know everyone's name, listen to James, yeah?
Jesus.
But listen to this, yeah? But Jesus said the Father is greater than I, and you said they are equal.
The Father and the Son make any sense. They are not equal.
He's been humbled. He's been humbled. No.
The Father and the Son are not equal. He's setting a good truth.
He's saying that. Tell me.
They are not equal.
Okay. If he was humble, was he speaking the truth? Or was he lying?
No.
When Jesus said the Father is greater than I, was he speaking the truth or was he lying?
He was speaking the truth.
No, I'm speaking the truth. So you're speaking the truth?
I'm not going to allow you to trip me.
What I'm saying to you, so when Jesus said the Father is greater than I, he was speaking the truth. That's it. So you telling me they're equal, but Jesus said the Father is greater than I. So logically speaking, we should follow Jesus, not you. Logically speaking, we should follow what Jesus said. Jesus said the Father is greater than I. Look, James, yeah?
Not because.
The whole point I'm making, the foundation of Christianity, out of respect, doesn't make any sense and does not, and it cannot be explained.
You have any right? You made a wrong
statement. Yeah, there's no right.
You're a liar. I changed my mind.
You're a liar. But there's a Bible.
25 times a day, and do what it could be. It doesn't amount to the same.
Okay, let's ask TV for Jesus. Sorry. A man came to Jesus, a young boy came to Jesus. He said, "Oh, good master, what should I do to inherit the kingdom of heaven?" Jesus, you know what he said to him? He said, "Keep the commandments of God." So the young boy is asking Jesus, "What should I do to enter the kingdom of heaven?" Jesus, that was the best time to tell him, "Just believe I'm going to die for your sins and you'll be fine." No, Jesus, you know what he said, Jesus? Jesus said, "Keep the commandments of God," which is the Mosaic law. The young boy said, "I've been doing it since I was young." Jesus said, "You are lacking one thing." He said, "What is it?" He said, "Give you where you go away and follow me." So according to Jesus, in order for you to enter the kingdom of heaven, you have to keep the commandments of God and follow Jesus' teaching. Okay? That's what Allah said in the Quran. No, it's not, because Ezekiel 18:20.
Ezekiel 18:20.
Yeah, Ezekiel says, "If someone commits wickedness and he repents from it, will be forgiven." I'm rephrasing, but he doesn't have to die for no one. You understand? And also, in Ezekiel, he says, if you commit sin, and you 18:20, and if you turn away from it, God will not judge you.
Repentance.
Yeah, you repent. You don't have to kill no one.
But it still needs, God is a holy, just God. Yeah. It still requires sacrifice.
No, here. No. The one who sin is the one who will die, okay? The child will not share the guilt of the parent. Nor will the parent share the guilt of the child. The righteousness of the righteousness will be credited to them, and the wickedness of the wickedness will be charged against them. So according to Mosaic law, if you commit sin, no one should be responsible for it. No one should be responsible. No.
It says here, no one should be responsible.
But in the Bible, according to the New Testament, that if you die, you will die.
Yes, sir.
If you commit sin, you will die. If you commit, Jesus died for people's sins. No, but what I will tell you, look, I'm going to make it clear to you, James. Who is cursed?
Who's cursed?
Yeah, Satan. Is God cursed? God is holy. Is God holy or cursed?
Yeah, but the Son made himself a curse.
Okay, so
take out.
Okay, so is God holy or cursed? All the time?
Yeah.
All the time?
Yeah.
So we made himself cursed. No, wait, I'm sorry. So but you just said God holy all the time. So when he was cursed, that's contradiction. Oh, he's cursed. Come on, James, man. Well, I'll be honest, James. Come on, man. Come on, bro. Be honest, man.
James, be honest, bro.
Off camera. But it doesn't make any sense. You can't...
The Father had to separate himself from the Son.
Sure. Yeah, but you believe the Son is God as well.
But then he came back to death.
No, but he never came back by himself. According to the Bible, the Father put him back to
life.
Yeah, but God is not in need of no one to help him. God is not in need of no one to help him.
He's got the Son.
Yeah, but God, I'm talking about God. He's Jesus God. No, okay. Let me make it more clear. Is Jesus fully God? Fully God?
I'm fully man.
No,
fully God and fully man.
Is Jesus a perfect God? Perfect God. Perfect God. I don't like it. I'm speaking to him honestly with sincerity. I don't like this game and joking around. Please. I'm saying to you, if Jesus is fully God, he's a complete God, he's one God, correct? So, by definition, God is perfect and is not in need of no one. Regardless, what is he? If he's God, by definition, he's not in need of no one. The fact that Jesus, he was asking for help from someone else, he cannot be the same God which Abraham believed in, which Jesus believed in, which Prophet Muhammad believed in. Allah, James, think about it deeply. Seriously.
It's not
the same. Do you know what in the Old
Testament says?
James, you know what in the Old Testament says? Anyone that is hanged is cursed. Hanged is cursed.
Yeah,
yeah, well, I'll speak to you off camera, maybe inshallah, we'll be much better. All right, James. How is MMA? You see the MMA?
Good,
yeah? Ahad is doing good. Inshallah. Okay, after I will speak.
Very interesting video. It actually makes sense. If God actually said, my Father is greater than I, who are you to start praising him or worshiping him? But then when I think of, it's not like, how can I put it? I don't think Christians praise God. They just think he's the last messenger of God. So to reach through God, he is the middleman. I don't know why, but that's how I look at it. Also, for the fact that when Jesus was crucified, Christians need to be open to, people should, not just Christians, people should just be able to understand that if someone can be crucified and still pray to someone who's higher than them, then it means something. So Jesus can't be God if he was praying to someone when he was being crucified. He was praying to God, which makes him as humanly as the rest of us. Although everyone knows that Jesus was the messenger, so why do we have to trouble ourselves by saying Jesus is God? Which I don't understand. Otherwise, this was very interesting. A big shout out to the person that suggested this. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.